Hello, ciao and welcome, benvenuti e benvenute all'Italian at Warwick. I am Dr. Valentina Battelli and I'm the language coordinator in Italian studies here at Warwick. I will be talking today about our approach to language teaching and also giving you details about language progression from beginners to advanced level if you start studying at Warwick. So why study Italian? It can be because of Italian heritage or because you have a passion for the language and the culture. But you can also think of the advantages of knowing a niche language like Italian from the employment point of view, from business to translation to journalism. Here you have an article from The Guardian of last year, where actually one of the reporters from Italy was highlighting how important it was to read Italian and how it became more and more relevant due to the impact of the pandemic to know what scientists were saying correctly. But also a report from the British Council of a few years ago was actually saying that knowing Italian is like having a golden star on your CV, because only 2% of the British population could hold a basic conversation in Italian. So if you already have knowledge of Italian, or if you want to start it and trying this new language and culture during your degree, you will develop a lifelong appreciation of Italian language and culture. And this won't mean only having an in-depth knowledge of one language and one culture, but also having the tools and know how to apply that knowledge to global phenomena, which is our ethos at Warwick. So you can take Italian as a beginner in any of our degree combinations, including Italian and English, Italian and History, Italian and Economics. So if you are interested in languages but you want to try out something new at university, a joint Italian degree would be actually ideal. And if you already know Spanish and French, adding Italian would be a very good choice. You will find the beginner's module very approachable, and as Italian is a Romance language, then you will be easily able to recognize vocabulary and grammatical structures already in year one. We offer Italian in year one at three different levels. Complete beginners, as you see in the slide, intermediate if you are at GCSE level, and advanced if you have an A level. Then this is how progression goes on throughout your degree. So if you started as a complete beginners, you will continue in the post-beginners module. The same goes if you started as an intermediate. If you started already with an A level in the advanced module, you will move to Italian language 3 in your second or third year. And then in the final year, depending on degree program, entry level and time you spent abroad, you will end your degree with a B2 C1 level in Italian language 3 or a C1 C2 level in Italian language 4. Our cohort of beginner students is quite large. Around 70% of our students are complete beginners, so we have a very strong tradition of teaching Italian to complete beginners. The first year beginners module is an intensive language course. We offer 5 hours per week, 4 in the classroom and 1 of online activities. We will start from what you already know about Italian. For example, as you can see in the slides, I'm pretty sure you are familiar with many of these words, probably with almost all of them, from food, spaghetti, cappuccino, gnocchi and vino rosso, to famous character like Dante Alighieri or Leonardo da Vinci, to everyday words like borsa, giornale and caffè. We aim to bring you at the end of year one to AS level, certainly post GCSE in the beginners module. So at the end of year one, you will be able to talk about yourself, your family, your daily routine, hobbies, describe your home, but also talking about events happened in the past and wishes that you have for your future. So in this module, you'll start with learning the foundations of Italian language and developing all the relevant skills, so grammar, listening, speaking, writing, and translation. But at the same time, you will be exposed to Italian culture through music and films, for example, and you will cover, we in class, we will cover topic on Italian regions, tradition, festivities, food, culture and society. Learning languages at university is different from learning languages in school, and there's a very great focus on grammar. However, grammar is always taught in context, and students use Italian from the very first lesson in the beginner's module. So you see here a few memes that we use in class: voglio un caffè adesso, I want a coffee now, or e tu cosa vuoi, what do you want? While on the right you see an example of an oral activity that students already are able to perform in the beginner's module, in the first class actually, where basically they present themselves saying ciao, mi chiamo, hello, my name is, I am from, sono di, plus the nationality, five things that they have, five things that they don't have, cinque cose che hanno o che non hanno, and then using adjectives to describe themselves, like simpatico, nice, alto, tall, gentile, polite, sportivo, sporty, active. By the beginning of term two, students are able to understand a class almost entirely conducted in Italian. As I was mentioning before, alongside grammar, students develop all the other relevant skills, so writing, translation, listening and speaking, and actually presentation skills. To give you a small anecdote of what happened last year due to the impact of COVID, we tried to make the most of our online environment. So when the task for students was to describe their home, students actually gave a tour of their home or their house during the class. So trying to combine actually the language knowledge and the presentation skills. If you already have an A level in Italian, you will start as an advanced student, and you will be usually a very small group. So you will have plenty of chances to practice with your peers and with your language tutor. Also in this case, obviously teaching culture and language are intertwined. For example, topics covered at this level are social media, social media, migration, emigrazione, and cinema. Continuing with your degree, you will familiarize with more complex topics, for example, living abroad, vivere all'estero, the education system in Italy and the UK, the environment, l'ambiente, and you will also learn to develop skills that are really useful for the job market. For example, you will learn how to write a cover letter in Italian, replying to a real job advert, but also, for example, how to write a blog post or an interview. At final year level, you will be able to express your opinions on engaging and up-to-date topics. To give you an idea of the topics we covered with final year students last year, we discussed about climate change, the Black Lives Matter movement in Italy, linguistic diversity, consequences of the pandemic on young people, Italy's relationship with Europe, gender and language. These topics are an example of how language module underpin the same ethos as cultural modules. So for example, we use Italy and we learn in depth themes that relate to Italy, but at the same time we engage with more global phenomena, as I was mentioning before, the Black Lives Matter movement or the gender and language topics that can be wider, that are part of wider issues and global phenomena. At this level, you will also develop real-world skills, and especially for not only for writing, but also for oral. There will be individual oral presentations, so you will be able to develop your oral skills. For the writing and readings, there will be closed readings, writing different type of texts, which would be not only the classic argumentative essay, for example, but also critical commentaries and opinion pieces and informative newspaper articles. To give you a more practical example of how these topics are covered at final year level in oral and writing classes, I chose the topic of inclusivity in language. So you can think that in the oral class, students have been preparing on this topic, watching videos and discussing with their peers, and preparing oral presentations, trying to reply to questions such as, Can a language be sexist? Può una lingua essere sessista? È giusto combattere per il genere delle parole? Is it right to fight for the gender of words? Come possiamo raggiungere le pari opportunità? How can we reach gender equality? In the writing class, students have been given an opinion article on the same topic, and you see the title of the opinion article on this slide. Una donna fa il rettore, ma rettrice si usava già nel XIII secolo. The news is the fact that La Sapienza, Università di Roma, so the university, the biggest university of Rome, elected the first female chancellor. And this event relighted the debate around the feminine of profession in Italian language. What is the reason? Italian has masculine and feminine genders. And the problem is that for professions that weren't usually covered by women until a few years ago, the feminine form is not very common, it's not very widespread. So that's what this news relighted the debate about. But you see, for example, in the slide that we have rettore, rettrice are the two words, the two Italian words for chancellor. So rettore is the masculine and rettrice is the feminine. And actually the rule is the same one that applies to more common professions like attore, masculine, attrice, feminine. In this slide, you see some examples of names of professions in the masculine on the left and feminine on the right. We've seen in the slide before, rettore, rettrice, you see that some of them behave the same, some others are slightly different. At the end of the list, there are two new ones in the feminine form, like ministra, minister, feminine, and sindaca, mayor. So students have been debating the issue around gender and language related to chancellor, to rettore, rettrice. They've been reading newspaper articles on this, tweets on this topic, and then they finally put together their own opinion article on this topic, but they can actually discuss their opinion through the informed readings and what they've been watching in the oral classes and discussing in the oral classes. So from here you see how at the heart of our teaching there's connecting language and culture. And actually topics covered in language modules are also tackled from a different perspective in cultural modules. For example, topics such as migration, second generation and citizenship are also covered in Transnational Italy and Destination Italy, while a topic such as inclusivity in language, in Italian language, is also covered in modules on gender studies. If Italian is your main language, then you will end your degree with a C1, C2 level, so almost near native level. This means that you'll be able to do the following things. You'll be able to understand and talk on complex subjects and write texts on politics, culture, and society in Italian, as we've just outlined. You will be able to understand films and TV without too much effort. You will understand literary and informative texts, and you will also understand differences of style. And you will express ideas fluently in a variety of contexts and for social, academic, and professional purposes. We strongly encourage students to go on the year abroad because it's integral to our degree and is crucial for language development if you started as a beginner. You can spend 8-9 months abroad in year 2 or 3. If you're studying more than one language, you can split your year abroad in different countries. And for that specific year, you will pay 15% of the fees for your year abroad. Current options that we have agreements with universities in different parts of Italy, so actually across the country, where you can take a study placement. There are also work placements available through language assistantship and through work student-led work placement. The study schemes that actually fund, that currently fund the Year Abroad are the Touring Scheme and also our Utopia Alliance. And other options that you might want to explore are the summer residences in your vacation times, and the school will be able to and happy to support you up to apply for these residences. If you decide to go abroad, you will have actually support from the school before you go and while you are abroad through constant contacts with the Year Abroad team and your personal tutor. Throughout the degree, we assess in different ways. We assess in more classical ways, such as with grammar tests or argumentative essays. I've already mentioned presentations and critical commentaries and newspaper articles, but actually we have other forms of assessment, of authentic assessments, such as e-portfolios and blog projects, which develop real-life skills that will be very useful for the job market and also transferable skills. So I hope you have now a clear idea of our approach to language teaching here at Warwick. If you want to contact me, if you have any question, you can just send me an email at the address you find at the top of the slides. You can follow us on social media. We're actually very active on Twitter and Instagram mostly. Grazie e arrivederci. Thanks and goodbye.